Well, good morning, Lionhearts. How are you? It's another day, another little bit of rain going on outside, off and on. Every 5 minutes I look out, it'll stop, and then it starts again. So I don't know what's going to happen today. This is going to be a crazy one. John hates the rain. He'll want to go outside. We'll go downstairs. We'll walk out the front door. It'll take about 2 steps outside the door, and then he'll just stop, look up at me, and then turn around and start walking back in. So I don't know what's going to happen, but I have to work the next 2 days, so I'm gonna try and I already have like two vlogs set aside for that because I already knew I was gonna be doing that either way. But I'm gonna try and get out and do something for you today too. I don't know what it's gonna be because I have to meet up. A friend of mine's in from out of town and I'm gonna meet up with him at 2 o'clock, so this can be one of those days where the day just unfolds right before our eyes. So hope you guys are well today. Hope you're having a great day already, or if this is the evening, I hope you had a great day before now. And I'm gonna hop in the shower and get this day started. Days with Jordan the Lion starts now.
All right, guys, I am actually pretty sore from all the push-ups and stuff I did yesterday, if you can believe that. Not even a fraction of what I used to be able to do, but that's just one of those things, you gotta work your way back up to it. So, killed all the juice, ate about 5 cans of tuna yesterday, and that was all I had was the tuna and the juice, and gonna make the juice now and then go outside before it starts raining, and I kind of have an idea what I'm gonna do today. All right, I'm done. That's what I got out of it. One full thing of juice, and there's a clean machine. Not bad. It took me about probably from start to finish cutting things, juicing it up, and cleaning that machine probably 20 minutes.
I try to never ever do three vlogs that are similar, like not even the same time frame. Like, I try not even to do, three golden era vlogs or, three modern vlogs or three music vlogs in a row, but because of the rain, I'm gonna go hit one that's pretty close. And it's another cemetery one, and the reason I'm going is because somebody just got moved there. You're like, what? Somebody got moved there? Yeah, somebody just got moved there. So let's go find them.
Guys, I can't believe this. I've never seen this, but from the moment that I've driven into this cemetery, I have not seen one open spot. Not one. Not one. What the devil?
Basically gonna have to walk all the way through the park, but like I said, the reason I wanted to come now is because somebody just got moved here. I just read that they were getting moved from New York to here last week, and I figured, well, they've got to be here by now. And there's actually two people I'm looking for while I'm out here today, but I don't, all I know is that Judy Garland was moved here this week from New York. And from what I understand, the reasoning behind that was that, and you can see the Paramount Water Tower there, the reason behind that was because Liza Minnelli and all of her kids wanted to be able to be buried next to her, and there wasn't enough room, so they decided to move her from where she's buried and has been buried and for years in New York to out here where there's a little bit more space for the rest of her family. And it's supposed to be in this Jewish mausoleum over here, which is kind of strange because I don't believe she was Jewish. I don't really have a lot to go on other than I know it's in this mausoleum. And I sort of found a picture of where they said she was supposed to be, where the family tomb is supposed to be. So let's see if I can't find it. I did just find this though. Wow, pioneer of our aeronautics. Wow, I wonder who's gonna play this one. It is crazy though, because I was wondering where Judy Garland had been buried recently, and then all of a sudden that just popped up. It was the furthest thing from easy to find it, but that's it right there. I actually can't get in. They have the doors locked right here. But yeah, they just moved her here last week. Put her on a plane last Tuesday, which would have been, I think, the 27th or 26th of January, and moved her out here so there'd be enough room for all of her kids and grandkids. And we, of course, know her from A Star Is Born and The Wizard of Oz. Originally, her name was Frances Gum. Everybody's pointed out that I messed that up in the time I covered Judy Garland's house. Frances Gum became Judy Garland. And they actually have named this the Judy Garland Pavilion. And you can tell they have a security camera right above it, just in case. But so new, they don't even have a marker for her yet. But I still wanted to come out. I still wanted to be one of the first people to show you guys the newest resident of Hollywood Forever Cemetery, Miss Judy Garland. And I'm going to see if I can find Estelle Getty, who played Sophia Petrillo on The Golden Girls. I know I found it here before, but I just can't recall exactly where, so. Sorry, I decided to just make this kind of a lazy day of vlogging, and just to see something that was new. Like I said, I hate to do three cemeteries in a row, but three cemetery vlog days in a row, but I thought this one was a little special. Well, I found it. Of course, true to form, the biggest one in this whole section of the cemetery, just like her personality, but the great Estelle Getty from Stop or My Mom Will Shoot, and The Golden Girls, and look at all the stones. I guess this is a good luck thing. It's kind of like leaving the pennies on top, because I've noticed a lot of the Jewish markers out here have those. You know what's kind of interesting about Estelle Getty is that for as good as she was, you'd have thought she'd been doing it her whole life, and she actually hadn't. I watched a little bit of a documentary on her, and she was a stay-at-home wife and mother for most of her life, and then when her kids both graduated from high school and went to college and everything, she got kind of bored and just decided to go out and audition for a play, and she booked it, and she was phenomenal. And I think it was like within a year or 2 years of her doing it, she was already really getting great write-ups and eventually was on Broadway, and that's how she ended up getting Sophia. Now, you guys probably know, she was much younger than she portrayed in the show, and she was actually, I believe, younger than Bea Arthur, but there was just something about the chemistry that those two had together. It was just unbelievable. They put some old makeup on her, put an old wig on her, and kind of gave her the Mama's Family treatment. And made one of the greatest shows in history. I mean, I love Golden Girls, too. That was, even though it's like an all-women show, and you might go like, oh, how do you relate to it? It reminds me of my grandma, and it reminds me of just listening to her tell stories, and her friends that would go up to the lake and play cards every, like, 1 week out of the year. And it was just great writing. They had Susan Harris, who was one of the greatest writers at the time for sitcoms, and she was really edgy. She was kind of poking in things that were going on in popular culture that nobody else was talking about in TV. She was writing in HIV and AIDS scenarios. She had artificial insemination. She had the right to die. I mean, she just really covered a lot of ground. And I knew since I was coming here to find Judy Garland, I really wanted to see Estelle Getty, too, because I've shown you guys most of the people that are buried here. I don't know if I ever told you that George Harrison isn't buried here, but when he died, his wife sent him here, and he was cremated here. So we've pretty much seen everybody that I came to see today, and I know it wasn't a huge, long vlog or anything, but you guys really seem to like my cemetery vlogs, and this is kind of the Jewish section of it today. You know what, guys? I lied. I actually just realized there's somebody else buried here that I wanted to see as well, so. And I've been meaning to do a vlog on his murder. I already did the research, I just haven't got over there to do it, so. We're gonna go see Bugsy Siegel's grave, the mobster. The man who, for all intents and purposes, was the starter of Las Vegas. Oh, look who I just walked by, without even realizing it. Bdeeb, deeb, deeb, that's all, folks. Foghorn Leghorn, Pepe Le Pew. We just talked about Pepe Le Pew in the It Happened One Night vlog. Sorry about all that, guys. I know I'm always all over the place, and I always say, okay, now we're done, or this is what we're going to see now, and then the next shot you see is something completely different. And I totally can edit around that and have thought about it, but that's the way my brain works, and so I just thought, you know what? If you guys are going to be going on these journeys with me, you just need to see how I get sidetracked as well. So it's kind of tricky because the monastery, or the mausoleum, I guess, is what I'm looking for, is there's two different mausoleums here with the same name after the same lady. So I'm going to go look and see if it's over here. I was apparently in the wrong building, so I think it's down here. This happens every time I come to a cemetery. I plan for I basically plan on like an hour trip, and it turns into at least 2 hours. Because it's just hard to, even with descriptions online, it's hard to find stuff, you know? I'm actually back in the very beginning building that I started in. But I really want to see it, because it's weird. I watched a couple of documentaries on Bugsy Siegel, and he was really like the first gangster to really kind of like woo his way into Hollywood. His daughter was saying that she could remember him having parties where he would bring her down to introduce her to Cary Grant and people like that, because they were such good friends. Look at that, somebody's leaving lipstick prints. Benjamin Bugsy Siegel. And he was apparently pretty ruthless, but I'll save a lot of that for when I cover his death, because his death's got a real interesting story. There's about two or three people that they kind of suspected playing a part in it, but they never really ever were able to charge anybody. And one of the theories was that it was one of the people who he was in business with in the mob just felt like he was getting too big for himself and wouldn't listen. One of the theories was that it was a jealous ex-girlfriend. One of the theories was that it was a man who Bugsy had pushed out of the bookie business, and this was his, that guy had basically made a deal with Bugsy's bosses and other gangsters to get rid of him. And that's always been kind of the theory. But we'll go into that when I go out to his house. And right next to the house where he was killed, it wasn't actually his house, it was his girlfriend's house at the time. That's like right next to, or two doors down from, where Howard Hughes had his big accident, where he was running low on fuel and the plane was going down. He was shooting for the country club golf course and ended up laying across somebody's mansion. So there you go. Now, let's get out of here. As much as I love coming to cemeteries and visiting famous people and paying my respects, it also creeps the bejesus out of me. I grew up watching so many horror movies that I constantly have that feeling like I'm in Return of the Living Dead 2, where like one of these crypts is just gonna come sliding out and people are gonna start popping out of there. Somebody was just buried today, and you can see the little tent where it was all taking place earlier. Must have been this morning. But I wanted to show you, you see those walls right there? That's actually Paramount Pictures. Paramount Pictures ended up giving up part of this property for the cemetery. So that's what's on the other side of right here. I was just walking past this one. I'd never actually seen that symbol before. And being a wrestling fan, not to be rude or anything, but as I walked by, the first thing I thought was, looks like the Diamond Dallas Page diamond cutter. Bang! As I was getting ready to leave, check this out. There's a cat and two, I guess, ducks. Just chilling. Well, even though I said I was gonna leave, I'm gonna show you guys one more thing. And I know I've shown you guys this before in one of the vlogs when I was out here, but since I came to Dorothy from Wizard of Oz grave, I might as well show you Toto's memorial. There you go. Like I said, I've shown you this before, but basically it says that Toto was buried out near where they ended up building Ventura Freeway, and so this is kind of a memorial to Toto the dog, which I didn't realize was a girl till now. And since he's right next to it, I'll show you Mickey Rooney also. This is pretty crazy. I've never seen this. I can't really read the name. It looks like it says Ashley David Layton Scott. I'm guessing he was a producer or something to all these movies, all these movie names. The Fan, Crimson Tide, True Romance, Top Gun, Beverly Hills Cop. That's a lot of stuff. And I'm just showing you guys all this stuff because I'm on my way out and it's right here. Literally, I'm just passing by it anyway, and I know I've shown you before, but I'll show you again. Mammy. Mammy from Gone with the Wind. And, if these ducks don't attack me, I'll show you, Johnny Ramone. Alright, guys. It's alright, guys. I'm not gonna mess with you. Get out of here.
Time to grind up some more coffee.
The lovely sounds of buses. Just a little California for you.
Well, guys, hope you had a great day. I think I'm good on the cemeteries for a little while. I'm gonna take a little bit of a break from that, but come back tomorrow. It'll be a great adventure. From Hollywood, California, your buddy Jordan the Lion saying good night.